sales numbers that will be trickling in over the weekend. Let's understand what the expectation is. We have Anish Rankawat, research analyst, institutional desk, joining us. Anish, firstly to ask you, overall the expectation is still slightly bleak. There was an expectation in between that probably we will see some bit of a recovery that will start coming in the consumption space as a whole. Mm-hmm. But you have coronavirus also, which has come in as a dampener. What is the overall view for February?
So, demand remains weak, long story short. There were speculations of pre-buying. That has not come, especially in the CV space. PVs has... I mean, the retails of passenger vehicles have been stable, but they're mainly because of high discounts. Mm. So we see in February month also, the discount levels are as much as what companies were giving in January.
Okay.
So that is one of the key reasons why we see some momentum in the sales. In two-wheelers, the problem is that a lot of the companies are now transitioning into BS6.
Hmm.
So there is a set of customers who are waiting for BS6, and there's another set of customers who are waiting for heavy discounts that could come in March. I mean, they're expecting it to come in March.
Correct.
And hence they're waiting for that. So we're getting this kind of response when we do our channel checks.
Right. So overall, if you go to see the switch that's happening, you know, to BS6 right now, is that having any impact?
Like I said, so I mean, there is a set of customers who want to get into the BS6 model straight away, so they are waiting for that. There is some supply shortage happening in the BS6 models, especially in the two-wheelers and in the passenger vehicles. Commercial vehicles are still they haven't started dispatching BS6 to that level yet. So we don't see, we can't say what's happening with the customer's thought process in the CV space. But that's what. So I think in February, most companies are tackling two big challenges. One is inventory management. So everyone is keeping a very close eye on their BS4 inventories. They don't want the BS3, BS4 transition, the high discounting that happened during that transition, that to come at all. So most of the OEMs are looking like they are in a comfortable position with their channel inventories. Barring one or two names, I guess, in two-wheelers, I think Hero is one of them who has very high BS4 inventory, especially in their slow-moving models like scooters. So that could be worrisome. Hero is, I think, giving some 5,000 cash discount as well.
Okay.
On some of these slow-moving products to liquidate them as soon as possible. But then I'm getting a sense that a lot of dealers are not very confident that they will be able to get away with the stock.
Right. So a decline expected in Hero Moto?
So I'm expecting a high, high teens kind of a decline in all the two-wheelers in domestic market.
Okay.
Hero on a lower base, that decline looks a little higher.
Okay. And what about TVS Motors, also similar trend?
TVS again, the scooters have slowed down a little. Especially the Jupiter model. I think customers are waiting for a refreshed Jupiter, which probably should come in any time. So I think that is the main reason why Jupiter has slowed down. And Suzuki, on the other hand, is gaining market share. And is the only player who has given a growth this year. I mean, they've grown by, I think, 10-12% this year. So I think they're taking a lot of share from the Jupiter model as well. So that's where TVS seems to be under pressure, and the moped again are facing the rural slowdown, and hence the mopeds are down, I think, 25-28% this year.
Right. And do you think Bajaj Auto is slightly well placed amongst the rest?
So Bajaj is well placed mainly because of its exports. The export markets are doing well. I'm expecting a 20% kind of a decline in domestic this in February, but because of good exports, the overall two-wheelers might only decline by 2-3%. This is what I expect for February.
Right. And if you have to talk from the passenger vehicle segment as well, and individual companies, what's your expectation if you have to talk about a Maruti, or for that matter, you know, the other names?
So starting with Maruti, if you recall, in January, they wholesaled about, say, 1,54,000 kind of a number. But their production number was way high. They produced about 1,85,000 or so. They started the month with already a high inventory at their end, which they which the company would wanted would have dispatched, and most of it is I think diesel, because in February they have stopped making diesel at all. So most of it would be diesel, and I think a lot of the petrol variants would also have come in. So I'm expecting about a 3-5% kind of a growth in Maruti. Moving on to M&M UVs, I think they there will be some issues, because company has come out said that there is some supply side issues for the BS4 production. So I think UV segment and pickup segment would get impacted because of the coronavirus supply issues. The tractors, I think, on the other hand, with good sowing in Rabi, Rabi sowing was up 10% by the end of January. That would have improved supported the sentiment. And I think there's, I'm expecting about a 6-7% kind of a growth in that tractor segment.
Right. And if you have to look at even the CV segment and talk about an Ashok Leyland, or for that matter, a VECV, what's the expectation, and a Tata Motors, because that stock has been beaten down a lot now.
Right. So, CVs, again, the demand remains low, utilization levels remain low, and we've not seen any pre-buy at all.
Okay.
So, looking at that, and in the quarterly con-call, for example, Ashok Leyland mentioned that the channel inventory is about 6,500, which I think should be sufficient for February-March period. So, I don't think so they need to produce anything in these 2 months at all, looking at the demand. Now, their own inventory was about 3,400 and the channel inventory is about 3,100. So, looking at that, I'm expecting, I mean, them to dispatch about, say, 2,500 kind of a number on the MHCV side. So, all in all, I think the MHCVs could decline by about, say, 40-45%. And similar for the other MHCV players as well. There's a high decline expected because of lack of demand.
Right. So, overall, just to sum up everything, there is weakness across categories.
Right.
I don't think so anyone is yet spared if you have to look at a year-on-year growth. But if you have to pick one or two names out of this entire list, which could just outperform?
So, Maruti certainly, like I said, is the only player with which I think can report a positive growth in February. Secondly, M&M tractors. Tractors, there's a positive growth coming. And you can say someone like Bajaj Auto, who is well diversified in terms of products and geographies, can also do better than others.
Right. All right, Anish. In fact, so that's a roundup of what you could be expecting from the auto sales numbers for the month of February. Thanks for watching.